everyone. So we're here today to start to prepare a horseshoe to be painted. So we're in the process of putting together some really fun decorate your own horseshoe kits for you guys. And those should be available early next week. So I have a few examples of horseshoes here. What we're gonna do today is an example of something that we often do during our summer program, the equine experience. It's a really, really fun experiment for the kids. So I have three horseshoes here. The first one I'll show you, this is a finished one that I did just the other day. This one is already spray painted rose gold. So this is an example of one that you'll be able to find in our kits. And then this horseshoe is one that has been kept away from the elements. So even though it's been off a horse for a long time, it's still in really great shape. This one's a little bit different than these because this is an aluminum racing shoe. This came off Caroline when she first came to us a couple of years ago, but it's very lightweight and it's really cool, so I kept it. And then this one, we have an example of a regular horseshoe with a couple of clips. This was in a bucket of shoes that I have that were left outside for a couple of months, and they are really rusty. So what we're gonna do today is use Coca-Cola to get the rust off the shoe and prepare it to be painted. So what you're really looking at is iron oxide all over this shoe. And so in the Coca-Cola, there's an ingredient called phosphoric acid that's going to have a chemical reaction with the iron oxide on the shoe. So you might think, oh, well, it gets rid of the rust. It doesn't really. What happens is the oxide and the iron oxide gets exchanged for the phosphate in the phosphoric acid, and then you end up with something called ferric phosphate, okay? And after that process is finished, I'm gonna let this sit for about 24 hours. After that process is finished, we're still gonna have to scrub this with a steel brush a little bit. The big thing that happens is all of this bright orange and brown that's all over this shoe is going to be exchanged for a darker color that's much closer to what we have on the shoe. If we can take a little close-up of this shoe, not all of the rust was removed from this shoe before it got spray painted. So you see in here a little bit, there's a little bit of texture, and that's the rust that's underneath the spray paint. Same thing on the back. It doesn't make a big difference when you go to decorate this shoe. You'll see in our next instructional video, the one about how to go about decorating the shoe, I'll be doing the beading and adding the wire to this shoe, and it will still look beautiful despite a little bit of texture on here. So this doesn't have to be perfect, but it is going to be much, much better. Now, once these kits are available, there will be an option to buy it with an original condition shoe so that you can do this experiment at home with your kids or your mom and your dad or whoever, and have a little bit of fun trying to change the iron oxide and then get your shoe nice and clean before you paint it. Okay. So let's go ahead. This is really simple. So the part we're doing today is setting the shoe up in the Coca-Cola. We'll let this sit for 24 hours and then we'll come back and take a look at it tomorrow and see how it looks. All right, so here we go. Shoe in the bucket. So if you want to do a little bit of extra research on this after you watch this video, apparently there was a Mythbusters episode where they talked about Coca-Cola as a cleaning agent, removing rust from things. There's a lot more science in that one. So especially if you decide, oh, that's better. If you decide to go ahead and purchase the kit with the original condition shoe, that would be a really cool addition to this video and this experiment. All right, so there we go. Move this a little bit closer to you. Even though that shoe has clips and they're sticking up out of the Coke, I'm not gonna spend another can just to cover the clips on there. So we're gonna leave this and we'll meet you back here in 24 hours and see how it does. All right, so it has been 24 hours, a little bit over. We've let this sit overnight. And now we're ready to take it out of the Coca-Cola and see the difference. Go. Much better, for sure. Okay, I'm gonna dry this off. Ooh, some of this is wiping right off. That's excellent. Great, so this is much better. We still have some textured areas all in here. I wish you could feel this because it's very rough to the touch. And when, again, we compare it to this aluminum horseshoe, it's very smooth to the touch. So the next step on this is that I don't have a wire brush. I do prefer a wire brush, but I do have this little polishing brush that has very stiff bristles. So we're gonna take this run it under some water while we scrub it, and then make sure we dry it really well afterwards. All right, so let's go do that. So the bristle brush, not great. We had some really good spots along the side on the clips over here and there that it did a really great job. But I'm missing the wire brush for sure because it does a much better job. So one of the other ways that I have done this in the past is to ball up a little piece of tin foil and use that metal on metal to scrape some of this off. So we're gonna give that a little try and see how much better it does. All right, let's go. So that was actually really cool. The tin foil was not perfect. However, I really love the effect that we got here at the end. Now I'm making sure to dry this really well. Otherwise, we're gonna end up right where we started with rust all over this horseshoe. Okay, so once I dry it, I will show it to you a little bit closer up how it looks now. I made sure to have a little point of the horseshoe so I could get into the grooves where the nail holes are. And you can see that the rust gave along the edges of the shoe much better than on the surface area of the shoe. But if we take a look closely at this, it's almost speckled where pieces of the iron shoe really come through. And I really kind of like this look. I'm kind of tempted to decorate this horseshoe without even painting it. So if I were to move on to the next step of spray painting it, which is super simple, do it outside, put it over cardboard or newspaper and spray from pretty far away. Make sure there's nothing around that you don't want to get spray paint on, and don't do it on a windy day. Those are my tips for spray painting outside. I do one side, let it dry for a few hours, flip it over, and then do the other side. And then I usually let it dry overnight before I pick it up and handle it, just to make sure I don't leave fingerprints all over the paint job. However, actually, I think these shoes might have come off the same horse. They were very close together in the pile. We are intending to paint these. It doesn't need to be perfect. So it doesn't have to be this color all the way around. This is totally fine. And actually, a lot of those rough edges are totally gone from this shoe. That is the end of our rust and horseshoe experiment. And like I said earlier, if you are interested in trying this experiment for yourself, our Decorate Your Own Horseshoe kits will be available with original condition shoes so that you can go to town with your Coca-Cola and your tin foil and have a nice experiment for yourself at home. All right, our next video will be decorating the horseshoe, how to bead the wire and keep it connected, and then some ideas of what you can do with it after that. So thank you so much, and I'll see you next time.